Happy Friday. So, I ordered 6 pairs of wedding shoes and all from Pink by Paradox, I think. They were the only good wedding shoe that I could find for people with big feet, like myself. I'm a UK size 9, in case you don't know. And two of them I didn't like because I thought they were really chunky. One of them I really liked, but when I tried walking them, they felt really annoying. And so now I'm stuck between these three. So I want your input if you want to give it. So there's this one. We'll call this the silver shoe, which is really cool on. It kind of looks like a Disney princess. Sorry, my shadow is really annoying. Kind of looks like a Disney princess shoe. This one is quite a traditional wedding shoe, which is what I quite like about it. So we'll call this one silver, traditional, and gold. This is a traditional wedding shoe, and really sorry about my shadow. And yeah, I quite like that. And then this one is just, this looks so cool. It looks so art deco 1920s on your foot. And I just really like the colour as well. So I'm really, really torn between these three. I'm going to try them all on again tonight and walk around in them a bit. God, my hair. Walk around in them in a bit to see what they look like on. And then after I've done that, maybe the selection will have gone down a bit. In which case, I'll let you know. But I'm going to try and make a decision very soon because I need to send 5 pairs of shoes back. I got them via Debenhams, but these people do have their own website. But yeah, so I need to send 5 pairs back. I also got another pair from Asos, which I need to send back, but they're all packed away, so I can't show you. But they were this material, sort of white satin material, but they were a bit like this, except they had, this is kind of a forward ankle join. The one from Asos was an actual like around your ankle, and one of the straps that goes around your ankle was really long and the other one was really short. And so for me, that just put me off because I just think there should be a bit of consistency. They were really cheap, but I just thought I'd give them a go. They were like 25 quid and I had a £10 voucher, but they're going back because they're just dreads. And the heel was much higher than it was advertised as well, so they go back. Anyway, I'm not going to tell you what's happening this weekend until tomorrow, which you'll see in about 2 seconds, because it's really exciting and I don't want to get myself excited before bedtime. Not that it's bedtime yet, but it's 5 to 7, so, you know, a couple of hours. Oh, pardon me. Leaning, boo against the wall. You're like a cat. You are. You're like a little puss cat. Oh. Good morning, everyone. Today's the first day that we haven't done coffee, crystal maize and croissant because, 2 reasons, crystal maize finished last week and second reason is Alex had to go to work at 7 a.m. this morning, so obviously he couldn't chillax. So Heidi and I have just been watching TOWIE in bed. But the big reveal, what's happening today, oh my goodness, it is windy hell. Outside, look how windy it is. Although it stops, hello, you still see. So we're going to. Oh dear, this fell down. I need 2 hands. We're going to Harry Potter the Theatre Show. I'm so excited. We won Friday 40 last week. Alex did. There's a big fat squirrel on my fence. Don't know if you can see him. He's huge. So we're going to see part 1 at 2:30. Then we're going to go to Shake Shack, which I'm so excited about. And then the second show is at 7:30. I'm so excited. I read the screenplay in Florida when I was there when we got engaged just over a year ago. And I remember the basics, but I don't really fully remember it. So I'm really, really excited. And we've got amazing seats. They're like 4th row center. And they were £40 each. And usually the tickets are £160 each, I think. And the wait list to see both on one day, I think, is until February. And not very good seats, according to Alex. I haven't done this research myself. And so we're really excited. I'm so excited, like dying with excitement. Anyway, we were supposed to leave about half an hour ago, but because Alex was working, he was late. Which I knew was going to happen because Alex is always late. So sort of mentally prepared that we would be leaving around 11:30 instead of 11, which was the desired time. Because I just want to go, not have to worry about getting there. And then I thought we could, if we were early, we could just mosey around the Westgate Centre. So there we go. Not a problem. I've not eaten today, and I don't know whether to try and not eat until Shake Shack or whether I have something a bit small. Because we won't be eating until about 5. So it's probably quite a long time to go without nothing, isn't it? Yep. Heidi's a bit hyper, so we're going to take her for a quick walk before we go out, because I always feel a bit mean. So I'm just going to do that quick and then go. So Alex took Heidi for a walk because, what's that? I mean, I know it's my hair. Because he realised that I hadn't hung his clothes up from the washing machine, that I didn't know were in there. And so I've just done that. Alexa, good morning.
Good morning. Today is British Championship Day at Ascot, the grand finale of the European flat racing season. The favourite in the Queen Elizabeth II Stakes is Ridchester, running at 5-2.
All right, maybe I should bet, except I'm not going, and I don't want to. So we've decided just to go to Marks & Spencer and get a sandwich and have that on the way, because I am quite hungry and I feel like I won't last until 5. I mean, I will last, obviously. I won't diminish and crumble. But, you know, I might make a decision at the theatre, such as having Maltesers, a bad decision, which I don't want to do. So, I mean, I might even do that anyway, because it's a special day. And I lost £1 this week, and I had a really bad weekend last weekend. But then I had a really good diet day on Monday and Tuesday. In fact, I've been really good all week. So I think what I've learned is that, which I don't know if it's a good thing or bad thing, but if you have a bad diet day, pick yourself up the next day and start again, because it doesn't mean you've lost it, and to not carry on, basically. And any £1 this week is not brilliant. I appreciate that, but I'm just happy to be losing weight at all. And so now I'm ahead of target by £1.5. Because I told you guys last weekend that I'm trying to lose £4 a month, which is definitely achievable. And I've already hit my October target, so now I'm into my November target by £1.5. So that's good. That's exciting. So, yeah. Anyway, I'll see you. I might show you what I get for lunch from Marks & Spencer, because I feel like I haven't had lunch from Marks & Spencer for so long on my diet. I just get this. Well, I do, actually. I always have porridge for lunch from Marks & Spencer. Their ready-made porridge is really good, and it's really filling, and it's just an easy thing to have at work. I was about to say at school then, at work. And so I never have sandwiches, and I really want a sandwich. I'm so excited for a sandwich. God, my Saturdays revolve around food. I need to stop that. But, you know, when you're celebrating Harry Potter, that's how it goes. Turkey feast sandwich! So excited! Woo! Just got into Westfield and we're gonna have to go into the Disney store for reals. So that's where we go. Right?
Yeah.
Who's your favourite character? Stitch? Oh, look, these are new. What are these? You Foofy? Like round Simpsons instead of flats. Quite like this jumper because it has Mickey Mouse pop out. It's quite cool, little bubbly thing. It's like obsession with mugs. Oh, look it! It's us! Eve and Wally! and a heart. That's so cute. Oh, careful. It's so cute.
Babe.
Yes.
For the mic.
Don't do that. That's scary, right? I love these. I love this. Oh, they just brought these over. We've got these two. Except I think ours is a bit different to this one. How soft is this jumper look? This pajama jumper. Look, it feels as soft as it looks. This also looks very soft. It's very soft. Look, they're finally selling these. We got ours in Disney World, but they're in stock if you want them. What are these things? Flavoured lip balm. That's cute.
Plastic.
That is plastic. Look what we found. This is all direct from Disney. Got some good stuff in here. Cogs are the plates. They're really cool. The bowls are massive. We're getting this cookie jar. How cool is this? Show the back. How awesome is that? Loves it. And I'm getting these. Jack Skellington and the poison apple, which is kind of colourful. How scary is Olaf's face in there? I mean, frightening. Kind of reminds me of Roger Rabbit. Just outside Burberry while Alex goes to the loo. And this bag here, the green tartany one, that used to be my school uniform. So I really like it. They do some trousers, I'll show you. I really like these trousers. I love them because they really remind me of my school uniform. How weird's that? Look, Bentley have done a 4x4. Bentayaga, probably. Ooh, we're here.
Oh, there.
Oh, that's, let's see it. The nest. Alex had to run ahead because we were fucking around for too long. We've got like 3 minutes to get there. But I don't know if I can get in and out here now. We shall see.
I'm gonna get it. Find the ticket for the first part again. Because I wanna see.
We just finished part one, so we're going to Shake Shack to get something to eat. What did you think of the first part?
It was bloody awesome.
It is awesome. It's really good. Really good.
Yeah.
And it doesn't feel that long, even though.
My jacket, please.
Obviously, it's about 4 hours long. But look, there's Chinatown. Down there. It smells deliciosa. Anyway, I'm not gonna go down there. And yeah. So we're just gonna go get something to eat. And look how pretty the lanterns are. And we'll see you in there. Look at this guy's bike.
No one in the class.
Loves it.
No one in the gym. And you hung up.
We seem to be going in Chinatown to get to Leicester Square. Which is quite cool. What's that in the window? Ducks.
Yeah.
Ducks. More ducks. Are they ducks or chickens? Loads of ducks. Fried duck? Peking duck. This is pretty. I'm going to go into M&M World.
Yeah, they said if we have to be there on the seat. On the seat 15 minutes.
Okay. That's a good day. Okay, let's go into M&M World. Pretty. We're in the M&M shop. These mugs are cool.
Price.
Yeah, it's not a bad price, is it,
no.
Compared to like Disney? I do quite want some M&Ms. It's quite cool. Prosecco.
Eat
what? Oh, sorry.
different colours? Are they just different colours?
I think I've got an obsession with mugs. I think these mugs are cool. Sort of like the eyebrow ones.
But also like the pyjama bottoms. And I'm debating whether to get Alex them. These ones. But I'm worried they might make me hungry. But they feel quite cool. Got a bit crazy in there. Yeah.
Which one?
Let me show them what we got. So I picked out some unicorn M&Ms. And Alex got some spooky peanut butter in there. Shake, shake. Yeah. My little hot dog. These cakes are so cute. I mean, I feel like I'm going to be sick. It's drinking way, way too much. It's cool, Ronnie. Oh, it smells so good in there. Oh my god, these are so cute. Gosh. We've just been pootling around for a bit. I ate way too much at dinner and I feel dreadful. This is so self-inflicted. And I've learnt my lesson that I'm never having another milkshake in 2017. And I'm saying that on record. Because I just feel dreadful. And I don't want to feel dreadful. And it's my fault. Oh, the pain. We're in the bed in the second half. Getting ready for the next show. I won't give away any spoilers. On purpose. This is it behind us. In the second row. If you weren't tall, you'd have a problem.
But you can't really see when they come through the...
through the fireplace, yeah. We can, sort of. No, oh no, I don't want to spoil it, sorry. What do you think of the second part so far?
Yeah, it's cool.
It's very good. Very, very, very good. Really into the for the last time, Mr. Harry Potter. I think I'm slightly mental. So the show is brilliant. We recommend everyone to visit it. It was so good. It was so good. And we've just come to Oxford Street to go to the Disney store because it closes at 11 and we thought, or I thought, why not? So here we are. And there it is. We're right outside.
Pikachu.
Loves late night shopping. I've literally never seen the shop so quiet. This little glass ornament. Love that. Mm. Love blue. Is it blue? Mm-hmm. He's not blue though, he's like grey. Back to the old mugs. That's cute. These are cute. Did we see these? Yeah, I think we did. Cool, let's take him home. I do like these spoon catchers. I feel like they have more mugs here. He's quite cute, although I don't really remember who he is from Star Wars. Is he a bird? Ooh.
There's my Prince Charming and a pumpkin. This is the time to come. Look how cool these dolls are. I don't know what you do with them, but they're pretty cool. £110. Oh, I like this snow globe. And the pins. I like it all. Oh, I love that snow globe from Finding Dory. Oh, look at this Minnie Mouse. She's beautiful. Boom. Nightlight, that's cute. Bee had trouble sleeping. Loves her. She's all blingy bling bling. Pretty fancy smanchy. That suits you, actually.
Look up there.
What, the Grand Cafe?
No, here on the right.
Oh, Co-op. Co-op and Gaki. Alex and I are back at Westfield. I've got hair in my mouth. And then we're going home to bed. Alex is running a 10K tomorrow morning. So wish him luck. Poor Alex. It'll be very tiring having been up for work early this morning, and he's been working after work all week. He's been very busy. But he wants to do it.
Come the time when you just stay home after work.
Yeah, that is true. And I'm gonna watch Alex in the race with my family, and then I'm having lunch with my bridesmaids. They're gonna meet for the first time tomorrow. So that's good, if I feel like lunch, because I think I'm gonna be full for the next week after today. But we need to try and find our car and get home, see a happy little pooch, and get to bed. So, hope you guys all have a lovely weekend. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next weekend. It's a really, really low-key weekend, which Alex definitely needs, and I quite like. I'm still not doing my Disney videos. I missed it this week, because I'm so busy with my job. What? Okay. Look at these fabulous cars. Bentleys. In the valet section. Look at this gold. Gold Bentley. It's pretty cool. So shiny. That is cool. Anyway, Alex really needs the loo, so I'm going to meet him at the car. But I exactly know where the car is, because we parked near Marks and Spencer, which is now closed. So we'll see what happens. I feel like it might be over this way, so we'll give that a go. Anyway, so sorry I couldn't do a Disney video last week. I don't think I'm going to be doing one this week, because I'm working in another department, which is full of maths and formula. I feel really rubbish because I don't know what I'm doing. Woo, my bag fell. And also I'm trying to fit my job in full time. So I just haven't had the time, and realistically, this isn't the way to the car. Realistically, I'm not gonna have the time next week. So I apologize, I've missed two in a row, which I feel bad about. But sometimes you gotta prioritize, blabbling. Okay, so I'm gonna find my car. Oh, that's the way to M&S. The car must be near. Oh god. So I'll see you guys next time. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good time. Bye.